for me, God was only Allah. And I believe Allah never married, so no son for Allah. So I preached there that Jesus is not God. Then somebody asked me, who is Jesus? From the crowd. Maybe a Muslim, but he asked me, who is Jesus? I was preaching, he is not God. But the question, who is he? To know who is he, I read the entire Quran once again. 114 chapters, 6,666 verses in Quran. When I read it, the name of Prophet Muhammad, I found in Quran 4 places. But the name of Jesus, I found 25 places. There itself, I was a little confused. Why Quran giving more preference for Jesus? And second thing, I could not see any woman's name in Quran. Prophet Muhammad's mother name or wife's name or children's name, no. In the Quran, there is only one woman name I found, Maryam, the mother of Jesus. No other woman name. And then about Jesus, when I read chapter 3 verses, 45 to 55 verses, there are 10 points which Quran makes about Jesus. The first thing Quran says, Kalimatullah, the Arabic word, which means word of God. And the second thing, Ruhullah, which means spirit of God. And the third is Isa al-Masih, which means Jesus Christ. So Quran gives the name for Jesus, word of God, spirit of God, Jesus Christ. And then Quran says that Jesus spoke when he was very small, like 2 days old after his birth. He began to speak. Quran says that Jesus created a live bird with mud. He took some mud, formed a bird, when he breathed it into it, became a live bird. So I think that he can give life. He gave life to a mud, clay. And then Quran says that Jesus cured a man born blind and a man with leukoderma, leprosy, etc. Continuously, Quran says that Jesus gave life to dead people. Jesus went to heaven, he is still alive, and he will come again. When I saw all these things in Quran, my thinking was what the Quran says about Muhammad. You know, according to Quran, Prophet Muhammad is not the word of God, not the spirit of God, never spoke when he was 2 days old, never created any bird with mud, never cured any sick people, never raised any dead people. He himself died. And according to Islam, he is not alive and he will not come back. So there is a lot of difference between these two prophets. I don't call Jesus as God, you know. My idea was he's a prophet, but he is a prophet greater than Muhammad. So one day I went to my teacher, the one who taught me 10 years in Arabic college, and I asked him, teacher, how the God created the universe? Then he said, God created the universe through the word. Through the word. Then my question, word is creator or creation? Must clear it. My question, whether the word of God is creator or creation? Quran says Jesus is word of God. If my teacher said the word of God is creator, which means Jesus is creator, then the Muslims must become Christian. Suppose if he said the word is creation, he will be trapped. You know why? He said everything created through the word. Suppose if he said the word is creation, then how the God created the word?
Wow.
So he cannot say the word is creator, cannot say the word is creation. So he was quite angry. He pushed me out of his room and said, word is not the creator, not the creation. You get out from me, he said. So then when he said that, I told my teacher, word is not the creator, not the creation. That is why Christian says word is son of God. Then he told me, if there is a son for God, I must show him the wife of God. Without wife, no chance for having a son. Then I showed a portion from the Quran. Quran says that God can see without eyes. God can talk without tongue. God can hear without ears. It's written in Quran. I said, if that is the case, he can have a child without a wife. So there we have a big argument, and you know at the end what I did, I took my Quran, kept on my chest, and I said, Allah, tell me what should I do? Because your Quran says Jesus is still alive, Muhammad is no more. You tell me whom should I accept? After my prayer, I opened Quran. I didn't ask anyone, I asked only to my Allah. When I opened Quran, I saw chapter 10, verse 94. You know what Quran says? فَإِن كُنْتُمْ فِي شَكِّمْ مِمَّا أَنزَلْنَا إِلَيْكَ فَاسْأَلِ الَّذِينَ يَقْرَؤُونَ الْكِتَابَ مِنْ قَبْلِكَ لَقَدْ جَاءَكَ الْحَقِّ. If you have any doubt in this Quran which I give to you, go and read the Bible or ask the people, those who read the Bible. The truth is already revealed in that. So if you ask me, who made me Christian? It's not any fathers, it's not any sisters, it's not any bishops, it's not any cardinal, it's not even Pope. But the Holy Quran converted me to Christianity. So after seeing this, I decided to study Bible. And I went to a retreat center called the Divine Retreat Center, that's in India. And then while I was doing my Bible studies, there are a lot of points which touched me from Bible. The first day, Father John chapter 1 verse 1 onwards. In the beginning there was Word, the Word was with God, the Word was God, the Word became flesh. So my Holy Quran says Jesus is the Word of God. Now the Holy Bible also says Jesus is the Word of God. So I found it both is very similar. And I was happy to know that I need Quran and I need Bible both. You know, I was in a mood like one day become Christian, one day Muslim, one day Christian, you know, I need both. While I was thinking like that, again one more word I heard, that was John chapter 1 verse 12. Such a lovely word for me, because it's written in Bible, if anyone accept Jesus, Jesus will give them power to become children of God. In all the verses of the Quran, Allah calls the human being slaves and Allah is master. Master cannot love the slave, slave cannot love the master. I don't like to be called by someone a slave. Quran says you are my slave. But when I heard John chapter 1 verse 12, it says, if you believe in Jesus, Jesus will give you power to become